Hundreds of people are gathered for today's event at the old ruins of Ephesus, where one of the seven churches in the book of Revelations was once established. Today is the day which commemorates the first Pentecost 2,000 years ago, when the powerful advent of the Holy Spirit gave birth to the first churches. 1,200 Christians from 33 countries and 700 local Turkish Christians are attending to celebrate this day together. Turkey is a spiritually barren country where 99% of the population are Muslim. There are only 4,000 Christians in the entire country, and more than 10% are gathered here tonight. Turkish churches are typically very small, with as little as 1 to 50 members in the congregation. It must be a striking experience for them to see such a huge number of Christians gathered in one place.
I am feeling like last 2 days I'm like flying, like I'm an eagle.
Okay, where are you from?
I'm from Turkey, Istanbul.
Alright.
Like the blessing in my country. I've seen first time this much people praying and immersing and financially and spiritually immersing for this country.
I think I am so grateful to the Koreans for doing so much for us. As Turks and foreigners, we are so grateful that you came to Turkey and you have blessed us so much.
Paul사도가 여기서 설교하다가 붙잡혀가지고 질질 끌려서 이 길을 끌려가지고 복음이 땅에서 다 없어진 줄 알았지만 바울이 전하던 복음이 땅을 돌고 돌아서 우리 한국인들까지 전해져가지고 이제 그 복음을 가지고 다시 터키 땅으로 우리가 돌아왔습니다. 할렐루야! 아멘!
The celebration began with Turkish folk performances and ended with praise and worship to decorate the dark blue sky of Turkey with the name of İsa, which means Jesus in Turkish. Attendees, local pastors, and workers have been attending prayer meetings from dawn to night, beginning 4 days before the celebration. The prayer meetings are held at Izmir, a small city near Ephesus. The prayer meetings and celebration are the two main programs of 2010 United Prayer Meeting, or UPM for short. The main purpose of UPM is unity and intercessory prayer. Praise, messages, and prayer meetings run in three different languages: English, Turkish, and Korean. As they pray for the revival of Turkey and for the Muslim countries, they become one in spirit.
The 에베소 연합 중보 기도회는 처음부터 이 안에 계신 선교사님들이 90% 이상의 숫자가 모여가지고 와서 기도해달라, 기도뿐이 없다는 그러한 그 요청이 있었고요. 그 외에 더 중요한 것은 이 터키에 있는 개신교 협의회에서 목사님들이 모여가지고 한 마음으로 바로 기도뿐이 없습니다. 여러분들이 들어와서 기도해 주실 때 이 터키에 있는 극소수의 기독교인들과 교회는 큰 힘을 얻을 겁니다 하면서 그들이 한 마음으로 우리를 또한 초청해 주셨고요. 특별히 이슬람 세계에서는 영적 세계, 영적 그 전쟁이 가장 중요한 그 역할을 감당하고 있기 때문에 기도뿐이 없다는 것을 처음부터 알았고요. 기도를 통해 이 땅을 축복하고 또 연합 기도를 통해 한국인들 뿐만이 아니고 중보 기도하는 모든 세계 중보 기도자들과 또한 이곳에서 이미 사역하시고 계신 모든 사역자들과 또한 이 터키 현지 기독교인들이 한자리에 모여서 기도한다는데 굉장히 큰 의미가 있습니다.
The celebration emphasis or the prayer time, more than the celebration, of course, is significant for the Turkish believers in a number of ways. One is, of course, there is the spiritual battle that goes on. And to know that others are with us in that, and that we are lifting up more prayer. Because we really know that we are dependent on God. He is the one who must move hearts. He is the one who must do things. He is the one who must build his church. We are very aware of that. We want to come alongside, but we know that prayer is essential in this.
As we were about 1,200 different Christian servants of God from the country of Korea, from the Turkic world, from the Latin American world, from the United States, as one family, we were celebrating together in that event the oneness in Jesus Christ. Zakai, who is the president of the church, the chairman of the churches throughout this nation of Turkey, was saying how that love overflowed, that love of Christ last night with the Korean and the Turkic pastors and the Hispanic leaders and others. There was the love of Christ overflowing, filling. So our hope is that Christ will fill all in all. That's the purpose of God through the church, the body of Christ. We experienced that last night, and we're very thankful for
Turkey was once the capital of the Christian world, but has now become the center of Islamic religion and leading persecuting country of Christianity. Turkish residents must identify their religious affiliation on their ID cards. If they mark Christianity as their religion, they can expect severe social harassment and be thrown out from their families. 주님이 On April 2007, three Christians were killed by five radical nationalists at Malatya, Turkey. This event proved that the most urgent issue for Christians in Turkey was to overcome such persecution. Unity and intercessory prayer was the only solution. Thus, UPM was initiated by local church leaders to make a breakthrough to meet this need. There were much blessings and fruits as a result. UPM is a great example of a new mission strategy for countries closed off to the gospel and spiritually repressed. In moving forward with prayer meetings and cultural festivals, rather than aggressive evangelistic activities, it avoids unnecessary conflict with the host country. This makes it possible to gather and strengthen the alienated Christians in Turkey. The intensive prayer in one spirit breaks through the spiritual barriers of the land. The Korean diaspora churches joining together in intercessory prayer group is found to be the most important role. After UPM, we witnessed many changes from Turkey, as well as from the churches that attended. The spiritual environments are changing. Pastors and believers in Turkey that attended UPM gained more courage to boldly witness Jesus Christ. Workers in Turkey experienced spiritual refreshment, which enabled them to encourage their ministries as a result. Mission organizations began to understand and cooperate with each other for the same vision in the Holy Spirit. Many Korean church members experienced that the atmosphere of the mission field to become an area filled with constant intercessory prayer. All these fruits were possible by the united intercessory prayers and the work of the Holy Spirit.